the owner of this domestic dwelling is having their fuse box changed, or we could call it a consumer unit, or the trip switch box at the bottom of the stairs. And we're going to look at some of the reasoning behind changing that board throughout this video. The first one being, the customer wants to extend the wiring system by adding a home garden office, a hot tub, and possibly photovoltaic cells as well. And with a quick look, you can see within the board, there aren't enough spare MCBs to facilitate these new circuits. What they could do is introduce a board here by the side or underneath, but as it's in a pretty main area within the house, they've decided to replace the board itself. We will also see what other benefits can be had by changing the board. It would be metallic, additional protection offered by RCDs, as well as the introduction of a surge protection device. We're waiting for Matt from MJ Electrical Services to arrive, and when he does arrive, he needs to confirm the wiring system that's buried within the fabric of the building is suitable for a change of board. So let's wait for him to come and see that process. So he's arrived. Matt's joined us again from MJ Electrical Services. Nice to meet you again, Matt. Matt installed an EV Tesla charger that we saw out on site, but today you're going through the process of upgrading this consumer unit or fuse box, whatever you want to call it. Now, I might have misunderstood in the order in which you're going to do this process. So just talk us through how we've got to this stage and what the customer's going to get next.
Yeah, not a problem. So the customer got in contact with us as they're looking to make a few upgrades to the property.
Right.
They've got an external log cabin going in, solar PV and a hot tub.
Yeah.
So we're looking at either putting a separate subboard in, but we advise the customer that the board isn't compliant with 7671 due to only having a split load board. So we've come to the conclusion we're going to upgrade the board. We did some preliminary testing when we came here on the original site visit.
Right.
Did a visual inspection.
So you were taking socket fronts off, light switches fronts off, you were doing maybe some confirming that the earth's in place in different areas.
Correct.
And some plug-in live testing, is that right?
Yes, that's it, yeah.
So that's really important that that's done, and that's sometimes customers miss that bit out, that it's not just a physical case of paying for and replacing the fuse box, that actually has a lot of other work.
Yes.
You talked about not having compliant with BS 7671.
Yep.
The boards now are not plastic, they're now metal, aren't they?
Correct,
and there's a lot more, we call it earth fault protection when we offer by RCDs introduced, agreed?
Yep.
They also went through and you had a discussion with them about other things in the property that, correct, because this was 15 years ago installed, what other things would you suggest in need replacing?
So on the original visual inspection, we had a look around. We noticed that the smoke detectors had expired, the manufacturer's usable date. We had a look around. Another thing we just check on the visual inspection is bathroom lights. Make sure they're IP rated. These have been recently replaced, so that's not an issue.
So that's something to bear in mind, isn't it? So the customer wants an upgraded consumer unit because of more circuits going in.
Correct.
Great. Gives you a golden opportunity to upgrade to the latest standard, which is great, but there's other incidental costs, isn't there?
Yes.
And in some maybe older properties, maybe that includes maybe bonding or putting a green and yellow wire to the gas, water,
correct,
oil, etc.
Yeah.
You're in a fortunate position this time. You've got something in your hand there, Matt. What have you got?
Yes, we've got the previous Tesla, which is rare, the original domestic installation certificate.
So that's good. So when you give a new certificate out, it's really important that they keep that certificate as well, isn't it, Matt?
Correct, yeah. And this is great for us because we can check the readings against the original installers, just make sure they haven't deviated from that, and we've still got good readings.
Okay. So you're now going to change the board. After you've changed the board, you're going to do a full electrical installation certificate.
Correct, yep.
That means test all the circuits just to prove they're safe.
Yeah, so as we're installing the board, we'll be doing our dead test, so we'll be testing the continuity of the circuits, and then we'll get it livened up and do all the live tests around the property.
Okay, let's let Matt get to work. So while you're doing the scary bit there, Matthew, of moving the cables around, no power, no Wi-Fi, I'd imagine the customer at this stage would be a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
What's your thinking on domestic surge?
Yeah, so we offer surge as standard on all our boards. The way we sort of describe to the customer is that the surge device costs around 50 quid and it goes towards protecting your TV if you ever have any transient overvoltages. So it's a bit of a no-brainer, really.
Yeah, and the TV could be, you know, £500,000. It protects all the electronic equipment in the installation.
Yeah, all your laptops.
Yeah, that's good.
Worth doing.
Yeah. So yeah, basically connecting up the conductors now. Obviously a lot of pride goes into this stage here. You've got a formula in order in which you do it in, Matt?
Yeah, so we're just working our way from the left-hand side back to the right. It's just, this is a bit of an awkward one. There's quite a few cables coming through one entry hole here.
Right.
But yeah, it just allows us to dress it in as neat as we can there. So.
And I noticed you've left some spare breakers in there for these extended circuits in the future then.
That's it, yeah. Yeah, so we've got a 40 amp, 32 and a 16 we've put in there just for...
Which is a good touch. I'm not expecting Wilex to stop this range anytime soon, but it gives it, if it might even be you coming back to do these extended circuits, but it means that the breakers are already populated in the board.
Exactly that, yeah.
So as part of the testing process underway now then, I see you're belling out the end of the ring final circuit.
We are, yeah. So far we've got one ring out of three, so okay, so that means in the right direction.
Later on we can continue that test on, but yeah, like I said, at this point it's worth confirming at least it goes out and comes back.
Yeah.
So we're carrying on with the testing process now as part of the certification. Which test are you carrying out now for me, Matt?
So we're carrying out the air fault loop impedance.
So we're doing some live testing, yeah?
Yep.
Really important. This is the bit that I would imagine if somebody was coming in just changing the board and leaving having taken payment, they're not going to take the time to do all these and register that certificate, are they?
They're not, or even have the knowledge of what the readings mean.
Yeah.
So there we go. We've got a good ZE reading there. Happy with that.
So you're busily typing away now, Matt. What's the stage in the process we're doing now?
So I've just raised the electrical installation certificate. So we're just populating it here, starting off the customer details, working our way through to the test results.
Okay, and this will what, be emailed off to the customer as well as a copy for yourself?
It will, yeah.
Is there anywhere else it needs to be sent? You mentioned somewhere earlier on that it needs to be notified to.
Yeah, so we will register the job with local building control through an APIT portal. That just takes the certificate reference number rather than the actual certificate itself.
So we're seeing you on your laptop, so that's a modern electrician, I would suggest, and now we're seeing you doing some more testing. These are things that people probably don't realise are going to happen, have they, when they have their fuse box changed.
No.
So just talk me through the overcurrent protection devices that we've selected here and why you think they're such a good idea and why you recommend them.
Yeah, no problem. So we've gone with RCBOs here, so each individual breaker here has RCD protection built into it.
Right.
Advantages of this over a split load board is the fact on your conventional RCD split load board you'll have an RCD main switch controlling four or five circuits,
right,
and in the instance that there's an air fault and when that operates you'll lose half your board, which could be half the sockets, half the lights, your cooker, and it could just be a problem with your lights.
Right.
With RCBO protection, if you have a fault on one of these circuits, just an individual circuit breaker will turn off. So A, it narrows down where the fault is, and B, it means you're not without half the electricity in your house.
Okay, so that's the earth leakage protection offered by these individual circuit breakers and RCBOs.
Correct.
Just tripping off. That's really good. Now, can we level up the protection? Is there another stage beyond fitting full RCBOs like you've done here? Is there another stage that we could go to?
There is, yeah. So we can now fit arc fault detection. Very similar units to these, but they also include protection against arcs in the circuit.
Okay. And we're going to change these RCBOs over to see that arc fault detection board. So we've changed it over to arc fault detection devices that include the circuit breaker for overcurrent and short circuit, as well as the earth fault protection offered by the RCBO. Correct. It doesn't look any different to me from the outside, is that true?
That's true.
So identical item been fitted, but this now offers arc fault protection for series and parallel arcs.
It does.
We will see a subtle difference when we liven it up, because there is a neon underneath them where this test button is for the RCD that will glow. But from the customer's point of view, what's the benefit of them fitting arc fault protection again? Just remind us again, Matt, what's the benefit?
So with the arc fault devices, this is going to sense any arcing throughout the system, whether that be an appliance that's plugged in that's faulty, or whether there be a cable that's come loose in the back of a socket and it's sitting there arcing. Obviously, arcing creates heat, fire, potential hazards.
And there's the key word for you. This now offers protection against fires from those arcs that can be generated. Correct. We're going to get the cover on, we're going to put all those stickers on, and we'll just finish off then. So that's a full day's work completed from Matt from MJ Electrical Services in order that he can change this consumer unit or fuse box, whatever you want to call it. So we've now got a nice metallic consumer unit installed, but there was other things that he did. He's been round before he left and he's tested every electrical circuit within the installation and he's completed the appropriate paperwork, which will be emailed off to the customer. So let's have a look at the work that he's done. So as we lift it up, we've introduced a SPD on this end, surge protection device. And for further information about SPDs in domestic dwellings, check out the other video that me and Joe made. We've got our main switch here that turns off the whole of the electrical installation. And you notice something slightly different than the previous overcurrent protection devices, fuses that were fitted. We've now got this red light underneath, okay? So we've installed this time an arc fault detection device. So this device has overcurrent, short circuit, which we'd expect, earth leakage protection, but also protection against arc. So that's a level up from the installation that we had previously, so when we just had the RCBOs in. So we started off with a plastic consumer unit with limited protection for earth fault. And we've now got a consumer unit that includes protection from surges, protection from arcs, as well as every circuit having earth fault protection as well. There are other videos in this series that will be worth checking out, as well as the one that we've just mentioned on surge. There's also one called Does My House Need a Rewire? They may be worth having a look at as well. For further information, please head over to electrium.co.uk, and thanks for watching.